What is dynamic padding? In the Patching Inputs Together video, we have seen that to be able to group inputs of different lengths in the same batch, we need to add padding tokens to all the short inputs until they are all of the same length. Here, for instance, the longest sentence is the third one, and we need to add 5, 2, or 7 pad tokens to the other sentences to have 4 sentences of the same length. When dealing with a whole dataset, there are various padding strategies we can apply. The most obvious one is to pad all the elements of the dataset to the same length, the length of the longest sample. This will then give us patches that all have the same shape, determined by the maximum sequence length. The downside is that patches composed from short sentences will have a lot of padding tokens, which will introduce more computations in the model we ultimately don't need. To avoid this, another strategy is to pad the elements when we patch them together, to the longest sentence inside the patch. This way, patches composed of short inputs will be smaller than the patch containing the longest sentence in the dataset. This will leave some nice speedup on CPU and GPU. The downside is that all batches will then have different shapes, which slows down things on accelerators like TPUs. Let's see how to apply both strategies in practice. We have actually seen how to apply fixed padding in the datasets overview video, when we preprocessed the MRPC dataset. After loading the dataset on tokenizer, we applied the tokenization to all the dataset with padding and truncation to make all samples of length 128. As a result, if we pass this dataset to a PyTorch data loader, we get patches of shape patch size, here 16, by 128. To apply dynamic padding, we must defer the padding to the patch preparation. So we remove that part from our tokenize function. We still leave the truncation part so that inputs that are bigger than the maximum length accepted by the model, usually 512, get truncated to that length. Then we pad our samples dynamically by using a data collator. Those classes in the transformers library are responsible for applying all the final preprocessing needed before forming a batch. Here, data collator with padding will pad the samples to the maximum length inside the batch of sentences. We pass it to the PyTorch data loader as a collate function, then observe that the batches generated have various lengths, all way below the 128 from before. Dynamic patching will almost always be faster on CPUs and GPUs, so you should apply it if you can. Remember to switch back to fixed padding, however, if you run your training script on TPUs or need batches of fixed chips.